across the country in energy fashion and rent in a bright life. John has been with the Boston Commercial School for 15 years. He has been a vocational teacher, classroom teacher, and art teacher with a variety of age groups as well, as a committee head, supervisor, and is currently a division director with the only responsibility to South Summit. He too has presented across the country, and like Heather, is energetic, passionate, and likes to see the fun in front of him. Heather and John often collaborate on numerous projects in the school and enjoy bringing their message of the success of the daily priority of the arts. They are each other's professional men and head, and Heather is a practical man while John is the director. This is John Heather, and they're the drawing board.
Relays going around, but good morning to everyone. analysis with No Child Left Behind, with a lot of pulling back from those programs. You don't see as much art music being taught in the classroom. And I'm going to show you a little research in a few minutes about why that's probably not as very good. I think a lot of us are familiar just from your own experience.
Punch yourself in the arm, you'll be out.
get to know them so well that when they blink their eyelash like this, you know what they're feeling. You can help them, whether they're feeling uncomfortable, or they need to communicate, or they're just thinking out loud. You get this bond, this connection with them, and all learning stuff. Like I mentioned, we don't realize
here is just a little video of a road race.
two run, one lap over 1 mile school. That person gets the greatest cheer typically. Then you can do something that's very difficult, and you can very easily if you've done it, then you get this roaring cheer. I mean, that's priceless. Let's talk about moments.
So we have this quote up here that says, winning is a joy and a shame here. You can do it, and not be replaced by anything else.
And the winning isn't just the winning. Ride a stilt. If you feel today, even three steps on that stilt, I don't need to produce any scientific evidence to convince. convince you that that felt really good, that you felt really good about yourself.
Right, actually,
I don't like one title before it shoots out from under you and falls out. I won't need to give you any physical studies or any evidence that you feel really good after you've done
this.
You feel yourself moving on that. You're going to feel a sensation of accomplishment. You're also going to feel that your muscles start to hurt and grow and develop. Our children, we're going to show you a clip in just a second of how they practice with this equipment. And it's always geared towards a performance. They're going to go on stage and do a choreographed performance with certain music, wearing costumes, pretending they're Ninja Turtles or Transformers or something of that sort. And then we put this show on stage. And we invite about 1,000 people to the Native High School that actually this year will be able to see. And you have your family and your friends audience watching what you already know is awesome about yourself, and you put those two together, these kids really come off that stage glowing and ready for the next challenge. And the next challenge might be to tie your shoe, the next challenge might be to treat your friends with respect, the next challenge might be to write your name, but they are willing and able and ready to bring on the challenge. I'm going to do this cycle. How bad can we tie your shoe? I can go across the stage on a still. How bad can it be going to
so that you explore yourself in the craft. You can try that today. Get the chance to start going further apart. and will teach the students what's you'll practice on the 6 foot high unicycles. We have to climb a ladder, put them on, and actually when we first did it, I had to get a person to climb up the ladder, get on the unicycle, and I would hold her hand and we would run around the room for a long time. But that's how we teach our kids. Even with the unicycle, some of the students can't keep their feet on the pedals, so we adapt the pedals so that their feet won't slide off. So we try really hard to adapt so that kids are capable of doing
we didn't bring any pogo sticks. There's a height, weight limit on those that the teachers wouldn't let us bring them out here. As with all the equipment, it's a very step-by-step teaching. So that, like you experienced today, we take our time more with the kids so that they're always experiencing success at each step. That's what a lot of the teachers are doing in the school. Until they're able to be very independent on it. Several years ago, we did a whole, I think it was right when the big dig was very popular, and the whole construction thing, like jackhammers and such.
He actually walks 40 feet on the stilts now. The guy in that video.
He does?
Yeah.
Several weeks ago. Here's a bonding part we were talking about. we have open houses or visitors to our school, a lot of times they say, well, you guys only take the high-functioning children with autism, and of course they can do all these things, but that's the opposite of what's true. The students that come to Boston Higashi School are usually on the other end of things as far as the level of challenge. They've been in 3 or 4, sometimes 5 different programs, and nothing worked until they came to us. And then depending on the child, within a couple of years, they're doing things like this. And it's a real testimony to, I think, the physical education part of what we do. Here's the trust factor comes in. Will my friends, while I'm standing on strap, stay in that position?
Most students, all students, are without medication, and they're using
showing empathy and compassion, trying to communicate. We had one child when he was with the dog, he started to say more things than he had ever said to us in any other circumstance. Something we were just getting to. You don't have the variety.
Thank you.
the spectrum were raising holy heck at home and in their other schools and in the community. And the parents have, as all parents do, such a love for their child. They tend to miss the child more than the child misses them. Sometimes what that child needed was clarity. I need things made clear to me. I need to understand what's happening in the situation. I need to see progression. And a lot of times the kids, mom shows up, oh yeah, mom. And it's kind of an awkward moment because they're thriving on the fact that they got clarity. They got what they needed. And that whole emotional piece is much more difficult. But yes, we provide a lot of this is a big controversy too. Gluten-free diets and casein-free diets, since it's one of the interventions.
Diet.
So it's pretty popular with treatment of autism these days. If a child has a definite allergy to wheat or whatever those things are, then they can stay on those diets. If they don't, if it's just part of the fad, then no.
We need a doctor's approval for it, and we don't encourage it. If it's for behavior only, then we really talk with the parent and try to get them to see that we want to do it our way. But if it's gluten-free, and again, it's an allergy, then of course, yes, we always make accommodations for allergies. Wash their clothes, make their bed. So it's a little bit different, but they do have